Welcome to the demo on text clustering, which is a very powerful data science technique. In this video, we will take some unstructured text and then group similar looking texts together. Now, does that sound magical? My friends, there is more to come. In this demo, I will use the world's most powerful natural language processing coming from OpenAI embeddings. OpenAI is the company behind ChatGPT. The demo is available on my platform experiencedatascience.com. You can also try it out. There is no coding required and it will be fun. So let's jump in. Text clustering has got many applications. It can be used to analyze customer feedback. It can be used to group similar web pages in a search engine, as well as group news articles by topics and much more. In this demo, I will show you on how to use text clustering to analyze customer feedback. Now, let me show you a demo which is available on my platform experiencedatascience.com. And let me start by first selecting the demo on text clustering. The dataset which I'll be using is based on reviews for food items on amazon.com. If you want, you can also upload your own data using the add button. But for the moment, I will go ahead and select the Amazon review data set and make it ready to use. The data set is now set up. So now let me go ahead and use it. Here you'll see multiple tabs. Let me first start by showing you the data tab. I will select few records to show all the columns, and then let me run. All right, so here is how the data looks like. The data has got the product ID, the score, which is from 1 to 5, where 5 indicates a good review and 1 indicates a bad review. You can also see the review text. Now let me use the text clustering algorithm. Let me select the review as the column for text clustering. In addition, I will also try to get all of the columns for the final output. Let us try to make 5 groups or clusters. Now there are multiple techniques for text clustering and we'll be using the OpenAI embeddings. Embeddings are a very powerful way to represent words as vectors. With this technique, the words with similar meaning are located closer to each other in a vector space. For example, the words such as delicious and tasty, tacos and salsa, vegetarian and vegan, all will be close to each other in a vector space. OpenAI, which is the company behind ChatGPT, has already created embeddings for all the words in the English vocabulary. So in this demo, I'll be making an API call and getting the embeddings for each word in the review. You can also try out the TF-IDF, which is a less powerful technique, and compare the results. I will also save the output of clustering so that we can use it to analyze the clusters. All right, so now let me run this thing. And in a while, I see the results of text clustering. Each dot corresponds to a review. The color of the dot represents a cluster. For example, here I see a red cluster. Now let me hover over it and see the reviews in this cluster. I see my dogs love peanut butter. These are excellent. This old dog has been eating this for years. As you will realize that this cluster corresponds to dog foods. And this is really powerful. The embedding technique is so powerful that it even recognized that the word dog and dog are similar. The cluster for dog is the cluster 2, which is indicated here. My friends, I'm really feeling the power of text clustering. And let us celebrate this power with a little song. Now let us analyze these clusters. The output of clustering has been saved as a separate data set. So I will first select this data set and let me quickly show you on how the data which was generated using clustering looks like. The clustering output has the same columns as the input data, but in addition, it has also got two new columns, DIM0 and DIM1, which corresponds to the two axes of clustering visualization. In addition, it also has the name of the cluster to which the record has been assigned. And we can use this data for further analyzing the clusters. Let us start with the scatter plot. I will select the X and Y axis. I will select the score for the color of the scatter plot. I will make some more additional settings and then let me run. So in a while, I see the scatter plot, and let me first spotlight the cluster 2, which corresponds to the dog food. With spotlighting, the cluster 2 is highlighted compared to others. And here, the color of the dot is based on the review. A dark blue color indicates a bad review, and the green color indicates a very good review. So let me see some reviews in our clusters related to dog foods. This is a bad review with a score of 1. Puppy didn't care for this. And this is a good review with a score of 5. Cracks for dogs. Doggies sure love them. Now let us take our clustering analysis to the next level using the Wordcloud. It will help us to identify the meaning of clustering without manually eyeballing all the dots in the clusters. For example, let me select the cluster 1 and use the Wordcloud to see what it could mean. I will select the review text to make the Wordcloud. I will set the n-gram as 1, which means that I will make the Wordcloud for single words. Let me also select the top 50 words which could occur in a cluster. Now this is a very important setting. We will remove all the stop words, which are the most common words such as a, I, the, etc, etc. Now let me run. Drum beats please. Alright, I get the results, and cluster 1 corresponds to coffee. Awesome. With the Wordcloud technique, I can go ahead and easily find the meaning of all different clusters. Now just for fun, you can also change the color of the Wordcloud and make it look more beautiful. Now let us do one more interesting analysis called the parallel coordinates. It is a nice way to analyze all the clusters at the same time. We can use it to analyze the average score, which will give us an idea on which clusters have more average score compared to others. Now let me run this, and here is the visualization I get. You'll observe that all the clusters have an average score between 4 and 5. The cluster 4 has the highest average score, and the cluster 1 has the lowest average score. Alright my friends, hope you have enjoyed the demo. Please give a like, comment, as well as subscribe to the channel, and see you soon in the next video.